Hello, and welcome to the land of the bear, where native people will teach you a thing or two about respecting our land. The very air you breathe could easily be your last. You'd best keep your smog in your cars and in your factories where it belongs. Put all trash where it needs to be, not on the ground, where we grow our food. Littering the land might reap you more than you thought it could, for you might be found hanging upside down by your toes in your own feces, with half your scalp missing, or maybe buried in a hill of fire ants coated with sugar or honey. Won't they find you yummy? You don't like these threats. Then tell me, why is it you think destroying our home is so damn funny? You thought you were so smart coming across the water to Turtle Island and taking it over. History said you won the war against the native people living here. It says you were the better man, stronger in number, more powerful in technology, and that it was easy to subdue and diminish the red people you found here. For you were civilized, and we were not. If you were so damn civilized, why is it the native people are the ones who know if you destroy this world, you are destroying your own chance for life? And what is civilized about such actions? You can read this until your eyes fall out, and you won't ever get it, will you? You still do not understand about the safety of this land being to your best interests. All you care about is war and mining and other things of a destructive nature. However, you all know it's true. Trust me, the bear is smarter and stronger, and if you don't watch out, he will catch you in some stupid act, and the look you receive will put you in your place as the one who is foolishly silly. Neither of us owns the land, but you will not admit it. You think you do, and you can sell it in parcels and tax it and deed it to relatives and keep it in generations of the same family as property of so-and-so. But that is nothing but a lie. This land to everyone here is only on loan. We have a saying, this land is on loan from our children's children, not from our grandfathers. If we destroy this land now, we have taken away the legacy our children's children will claim, and that is unforgivable, an act against the natural order of the universe. Trust me when I say it is only on loan, and if you don't stop this shit, it will all be gone one day. What will your children do when they are gasping for fresh air, unable to breathe? What will you do, and where is there to go? Will it be a lesson learned too late? Must it be our fate? It will not affect just you, but everyone will suffer for your selfish acts. Who will make a stand? It needs to be done now. Stop destroying our native land of Turtle Island. This world is a place we should all be grateful for. It is a beautiful planet, and it is our home world. Take care and protect what we have. Our water supply is damn near gone, but I already know you could care less. I know you don't want to hear these words, but maybe some of you are not a lost cause, so I'm going to do my best to get this message out there to the few of you who have a heart and are willing to understand the dire situation we are all facing. With each passing day, that its steps to make amends and correct our errors aren't done now, there will come a day when it will be too late to stop or change the effects of man's careless ways. Think of how you look upon our land as a place of peace, and then turn around and fill up this precious land with landfill, a few dump sites which have poisons that leak into the soil and drain into the creeks, polluting our water, killing our trees. If we lose the trees, it will some be less oxygen, for they make the oxygen we breathe and use the carbon monoxide we exhale. Yes, every day the woodsmen are out there and the forest cutting down the trees, Clearing off the lands, removing the natural windbreaks for logging is a huge business and has been for many years. Do they care that they are destroying the land and the air? When you remove the forest, this also destroys natural habitats for many of the wild animals and birds. Do you wonder why moose and deer and coyotes come down into your cities and towns? It is because their homes have been encroached upon or removed, and they come down the mountains to the valleys and end up in your yards, and you cannot blame them. You need to blame yourselves. They are hungry and homeless. So where better to go than down the slope and along the rutted roads? You left the road for them to follow, and if they are angry and knock over your trash cans looking for food, go right ahead and shoot at them, but that will not solve the matter. More keep coming, and then what? It is time for our native people to make a stand. Do it now and protect our native land. My intention is not to make anyone mad. We need major improvements. We need all Earth's people helping out, native or not. But if all of us working together, we can make a big difference. Instead of throwing that snack package out the window, find a trash can to put it in. Save your cans and bottles and recycle them. Use cloth bags for shopping rather than paper or plastic bags. Walk if it's only a short distance. Exercise is good for you, and take a bag along to pick up trash. You find along the way, and you will do a lot in helping our land be beautiful again. I do these things already. I do these things already, and it makes me feel good about myself. And you will feel this way too when you start noticing others are also doing it, and they are not wearing orange jumpsuits, but our family is doing their part and teaching their children the right way to be responsible caretakers of Turtle Island, also known as America the Beautiful. Be proud of where you live and take care of her, and it shows us caring people who do exactly as we say. America is a land of liberty, and we have the freedom to do as we please, but we have laws in all states against being slothful litter bugs. And if you litter and get caught by the law enforcement, they will fine you, and you might even go to jail for it. There is nothing about jail time to be proud about. When you stand in front of a judge and are told how you just received the stiffest penalty they can give you, it will be too late. Why let that happen when it is much better to stop at the nearest trash can and put your trash there than it is to take a chance that it might start a forest fire and burn down the trees and houses, even take the lives of animals and humans? That is why they will give you a harsh fine at the least. So if you will pick up that trash, Great Spirit will see you are doing your part. He will nod and smile at his angels. Well, now that's a start. God is with you, walking beside you, guiding you along. He loves us more when he sees us actively doing what we can. Give him your work-worn hand. He will heal you, even as the land heals. Credit is due any who protects this native land. Like the mighty bear, I know you are smart in protecting your domain. But to better help you understand, let the bear show you our den. Come walk inside. Enter without fear, my friend. You are our guest. Inside the bear's den, everything is kept neatly cleared out. No clutter, no trash, and nothing moldy or scattered about. If you think you will see piles of bones, think again. Bears like to dig pits and will rake their refuse into it. They also leave carcasses near the anthills and let the ants strip the bones bare. Bears make their beds of piles of leaves, and when they refresh the leaves, they push away the old leaves and the crevices in the cave walls. They won't live in a dirty den because if it's dirty, they know they can get sick. So take some pointers from the bear and live in a comfortable, dry, clean home. Take care of what you have, and this world will continue being a fruitful, happy place for many years to come. So help us protect our native land. Thank you. The place where the cries, the trail of tears, the place where the cries. Thank you. beautiful is our native land.